Our next guest is a gentleman who we know is a favourite son of this football club. 139 games wearing purple. We know he served an apprenticeship as an assistant coach across the AFL. He's now the coach of your football club. Please make him welcome, Justin Longmuir.
Thank you all.
Must be nice to get that sort of applause in early December.
Yeah, it is. It's early days.
Having nightlight tonight, I know you've got so many things on your plate, including getting pre-season up and running, but having the members here tonight in such great numbers and showing such great support, that's just a small piece of the pie, but a very important one.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was thrilled to be able to come tonight because you know, I've long held the belief that our fans are the most passionate fans in the AFL, and to get here and meet some of you in person tonight's really good. I've also been really surprised and pleasantly surprised at how many fans have been coming down to training and watching our boys and investing in our footy club, because I know the players really appreciate it as much as I do.
Let's get on to pre-season, because it's all about what happens out on the field next year and beyond. How has pre-season started for you, and what have you noticed amongst the group, albeit early days?
Yeah, well, I suppose the first probably 5 weeks of pre-season is always a little bit disjointed in the fact that the young boys, the first 4 year players, come back before the older boys, and then you get the new draftees. So we've had a real focus on our skill development on the track. We haven't just been trying to kick for the sake of kicking. I've empowered some of our coaches to come up with a skill development program so that the kicks that we get at training and the handballs that we get at training are transferable to the way we want to play and on-field performance. So we've had a real big focus the first 4 weeks of that skill development. Now we're going to go into a phase where we start focusing more on our style of play and trying to implement some changes there. And you know, I've been really impressed with the way the players have embraced the new program and applied themselves.
You've probably been asked this a few times since you've taken the reins, but what sort of coach, can you verbalise what sort of coach you hope to be, at least aspire to be?
Well, yeah, well, I feel like a large part of my leadership style is to set a vision and then empower people to you know, go about executing their roles. And I feel like I've been able to inherit some really good coaches who are really enthusiastic about the direction of the footy club and what we're trying to implement, but also being able to get a few new faces in to complement those pre-existing players. I feel like Peter Bell has really gone about improving the culture of the football club and making it a really enjoyable place to be. So I feel like the foundations have been laid, and now it's our time to go to work and improve on that.
A lot of love in this room tonight. I'm enjoying it. It's nice to be here, I have to say. You talked about the coaching group, and you are a first-year senior coach. You need support. That's obvious. And you're going to get that from guys like Josh Carr, Aaron Sanderlands, and Mark Lacroix. So you've got a diverse mix of experience and history in footy.
Yeah, those guys have helped me immensely, but I don't want to gloss over the fact that I've inherited some really experienced coaches that have been around the football club for a long time. So they've been able to give me a lot of insights into the way things have been done and the traits of our players and some of the improvement areas that we can latch onto. Josh has been really, really good. He'll coach the midfield this year. And we all know how he played, and hopefully he can impart some of that knowledge onto our midfield group. Aaron and Mark bring that bring the fact that they're fresh out of the game. The players will be able to relate to them, and clearly they're at the top of their game in the roles that they played. So they'll be able to impart a lot of that knowledge onto our younger players.
And so much of the excitement about the draft week and a couple of days that it was what transpired from a Fremantle perspective. They're all young men. They've all got dreams to play AFL next year, I'm sure, at some stage. What do you make of them? They need to get in the gym. They need to learn so many things in footy, but there's so much excitement attached to them.
Yeah, absolutely. Our recruiting team did a fantastic job to not only secure the picks, but also pick the players that we had earmarked well before the draft. I think to become a quality AFL player, you need one or two standout traits that you can improve on. And I feel like each player that we've picked has got some standout traits that they can take into their AFL careers. The thing that has impressed me the most about our draftees as a whole is their characters. I spent a little bit of time with the two Melbourne draftees that we picked straight after the draft, and all they could worry about was their mates getting drafted after them, and they were really anxious that, you know, the players that they'd spent a lot of time with over the last 2 years, they were really anxious that they wouldn't get picked up, and you could just see the excitement in their face when their mates got picked up. And I really liked that trait in people, the fact that they care. And the other thing that they're really respectful of the opportunity that we've given them, and they're really keen to get over here and give it a crack. So I'm really happy with the way it worked out.
Absolutely. And we know that you say there's some quality young men there, and we wish them the best. We're going to speak to most of them in the next 20 minutes or so. Two gentlemen who are not far away from the lectern as well, Blake Akers and James Ace. They're both 24 years of age. They both bring some experience to the team, and I'm sure that that's a trait which you'll embrace with some young players coming through.
Yeah, absolutely. I feel like, obviously, you know, Ed Langdon and Brad Hill left at the end of last year, and I feel like we've already got some ready-made replacements for those guys. They are still young, both 24 years of age, but they've got some experience and runs on the board. So that'll be really important for our young crop of players who are coming through. We really need that older support around them to show the way, and I feel like with our younger players, their characters are really strong, and they've both had a real influence not only on the track but also off the track with the way they've spoken up in team meetings and driven the group in some areas.
Okay, do you get a bit of a breather over Christmas, hopefully, because you know how taxing it'll be come season 2020. There won't be too many times to exhale.
Yeah, but I knew what the job entailed when I took it on and applied for it, and it's something that I'm really passionate about to help this footy club get where it belongs.
Ladies and gentlemen, Justin Longmuir, your new Fremantle coach.